Dear students, let us continue module 5. In this lecture video, we will be studying the chapter code generation. So, what is code generation? So, here, as you can see in the diagram, that from front end, a source program will be coming. And all the 5 phases, it will take place. Code generation, it is the last phase, and that means it is the 6th phase of the compiler generation. Now, in the front end, a source program will be feed up to the lexical analyzer, then syntax analyzer, then semantic analyzer, and then intermediate code generation it will come, then code optimizer will be there, it will optimize, it will make them in a particular format, then intermediate code generation. After that, when the in the intermediate code generation, what will be there in the data, in the annotate tree or syntax tree. Then code generator, what it will do, it will take those annotate tree or syntax tree and it will convert into the target program, which is the assembly language. So final, this is what our purpose, that we want the compiler to convert source program into the target program, which is the assembly language. So let us go one line by line. The final, it is the final phase in our compiler model is the code generator. It takes as input the intermediate representation, that is, this input as an intermediate representation produced by the front end of the compiler along with relevant symbol table information, and produces as output a semantically equivalent target program as shown in the figure. So it takes the whole thing, intermediate code, as input, and it will convert into the target program, which is the assembly language. Then a code generator has 3 primary tasks. There are 3 tasks code generator performs. First one is instruction selection, second one register allocation and assignment, third one instruction ordering. So let us see one by one. First one, instruction selection. It involves choosing appropriate target machine instruction to implement the intermediate representation statement. So instruction selection, it chooses the attribute in which target machine instruction it has to be intermediate representation need to be converted. Then second task is register allocation and assignment. Register allocation and assignment, it involves deciding what values to keep in which register, because so many registers will be there, so we have to decide which variable value need to be, or which variable need to be stored in which register. That is the second task. Third task is, which is the instruction ordering. It involves deciding in what order to schedule the execution of instructions. Like we have so many instructions, so this instruction ordering, it decides in which order, whether the first instruction need to be executed first, or second instruction need to be executed first, or third instruction need to be executed first. So let us understand with some example the instruction selection. Let us assume that we have a 3 address code, x equal to y plus z. So how we can write the code generation, how it converts the statement x equal to y plus z into the target code. Now suppose here y plus z, right hand side y z. So first of all, we will load, or we will copy the value of y into register R0. Then we will use an instruction add, as y value is stored in, it is loaded in R0. So R0 will be added to z, that is a y plus z, and that value will be stored into R0. So this statement, this first statement will be written for R0 equal to R. Second statement, R0 equal to R0 plus Z. Then final value Y plus Z, it is stored in R0, loaded in R0. That R0 need to be stored in the variable X or memory location X. So we can use the instruction that is ST. ST means stored. So R0, value of R0, it will be stored in X. Now let us see the another example. We have one example, A equal to B plus C and B equal to A plus C. So in this one, what happens? Redundancy load happens. So this is strategy often produces redundant loads and stores. For example, redundant loads and stores will happen here. So let us understand this with one example. Here B is there. So first of all, we will load B value to register R0. Then we will add R0. R0 value is B value is stored in R0. So add R0 comma C. That means B value is added to C and that value will be stored in loaded to R0. Then next again A equal to B plus C. So the final value B plus C is loaded in R0 and that value will be stored in A. So ST A comma R0. Next, load R here. This is the second line. Again, load R0. Here actually it should be load R0 comma A. Means A value again it will be stored in R0. Then add R0 comma R0E. So that value A plus E is added here because A is already stored in R0. So R0 comma E means A plus E will be loaded to R0. Now, so final value that is A plus E will be stored in R0 need to be copied or stored in memory location D. So we can use the instruction ST, ST D comma R0. So here the fourth line 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth line you can see that here R0 value is stored at A. Again here A value is loaded to R0. So here in the fourth line you can see that redundancy is there. Here the fourth statement is redundant since it loads a value that has just been stored. And so it is the third, if A is not subsequently used. So, in third line, A value just has been stored, R0 value is stored in A, and that will be is loaded again to R0. So, here redundancy is there. So, let us understand one more statement here, A equal to A plus. So how we can write the machine instruction or target code, code generator, how it will convert this instruction into the target code. So A loaded to R0. Then A value is will be added to 1. So we can write R0 add R0 comma R0 comma hash 1. Hash 1 is nothing but immediate value. So here A is stored in R0 and then again in R0 1 is added, it means A plus 1 and that value is stored in. Again that value needs to be copied to A. So store R0 A comma R0. So again R0 it will be stored to A. So this is the statement. So thank you all. In the next video we will be studying register allocation. Yes. Thank you all.